Hi, this is Kelly with A Different Pretty, and I want to do a tutorial on this eye look. It is pretty dramatic. This would be something maybe I'd wear like to the club and stuff. It's really dark shades. I love smoky eyes. I could smoke out any color you give me. I love smoky eyes. So I'm just going to show you how I got this look, how I do my eyeshadow makeup, and go from there. I got from Shawnee's Pretty and Ink these awesome palettes from her Dollar Tree. She was doing some videos on Dollar Tree makeup she was getting, and they're just gorgeous. So I kind of used some from both of those, and then some gel liner and some glitter, gold or copper, the e.l.f. glitter, which I love, is my favorite. So I already did like foundation and some tiny bit of bronzing and mascara, and so I'm gonna show you how I do. I mean, you guys know how to do all that. I guess like some people might have trouble with eyeshadows. Like I've talked to a lot of women, and they're like, "Yeah, I just don't know how to do it. How do you do it? You know, blah blah blah." So this is how I do it, which I know is different than how other people do it. What I notice the difference is, and you know, and I always hear people talk about, their eyeshadow creasing or not lasting all day or whatever. I've never had that problem. It might be because the way that I do my eyeshadow. So this is like, you know, all day makeup, because I never, even when I touch up my makeup at night, like if I was going to go somewhere and I wore the makeup all day, it still looks just as great. I just touched up just for, just, I don't know why, but I do, but it really doesn't need to be touched up. So this is how I do my makeup. Okay, from this little palette, I'm going to start off with, and I do my makeup, my shadows in layers. So the first layer is this real pretty kind of grayish. So I'm going to go over, and I'm only using two brushes, and that's what I'm basically down to, is two brushes. I only do, out of all my brushes, I use these two the most. Defining eye and then the blending brush. And whenever I switch colors, I just go like this on the sides to take the pigment out. And then just go on. That's, yeah. People do weird stuff when they're at home and nobody's watching them, because I usually don't do tutorials. But it really was my idea to do a tutorial. So I'm going to go over this whole lid with this gray. And this basically is just because it's my highlight, basically for up here, but I still go over the entire lid. And also, I don't use a primer, and my shadow still stays on great. So, take it or leave it. The next one, I have to remember how I did this eye. That's why I hate doing them. The next one will be this darker gray. And this is like really pigmented, and it is full of gorgeous shimmer. So with this next color, I'm going to go up to here. I'm going to go over the whole lid right here, but not where the highlight is. So then it's, and that's the layering. And because it's so dark, I always kind of pat it first, so I see how much, what's on my brush, so I don't kind of overdo it, and go from there. It's kind of hard to do it at this angle, so I hope you guys can see me. Alright, and you know, anything that goes outside the area you're not wanting it to go on, you can clean it up later, it's no big deal. Especially when you're doing a dramatic eye, and it's good, it's gonna happen. You're gonna have some end up over here, you're gonna have some end up over here, and you're gonna clean all that up later. This polish is pretty, or polish, this shadow is pretty, it's pretty pigmented, so you gotta be, and I've only used it this one time on that one eye, so I'm kind of getting used to how it works. And I really super love it. Thank you so much, Shauna. So now I'm just going to kind of clean it up. And you may have to use like a little wipey thing. And some people like put tape there. I don't know. That's okay. So then I'm going to kind of blend it up here with the highlighted one, kind of blend it up. Now also lighten that up again some more. I know sometimes what goes out on the camera and what you're actually seeing and what it really looks like is two different things. So Anyways, I have that all the way down and then just 3/4 up, not the full. Okay, next I'm going to do the next, this is just how I do my makeup. So next I'm going to do the crease and I do that little V. So I have the dark, this one right here, that little tiny one is really dark. So what I do is, you know, I kind of pat it where that crease is and go down and then pull it out. So like that, if you could see, okay, and then pull it out. Yeah, I like to make all kinds of crazy noises because I can't stand it being quiet when I'm doing a video. So you can see, you know, I made the V, of course, the V right here, but then I bring it on out too. I have like super, a lot of eyelid room, so I'm able to kind of just, I notice with other people that I do their makeup, they don't have all that room to work with, which kind of sucks. Because it's kind of fun having that crazy amount of eyelid to just, you know, put tons of color on and then totally smoke it out. And I'm just kind of blending and softening up these lines. When I have it kind of the direction I'm going, I just kind of blend that out and soften it up. So even though it's a dramatic look, it's not so hard of a line. Now at this point, I may add like color. Well, another thing I did too, and let me just show you really quick, because I kind of felt like that highlighted wasn't quite what I was wanting. So I went ahead and took this one. This one was called the Natural Eye, and then the darker one is called the Smoky Eye. So I took some of this, the lightest color, and then kind of just went back over that and gave it more of a, now I'm just cleaning the brush off after I did that, and then blend that in. I didn't think it was quite as light, but I had to show you how I did this other eye, or else it wouldn't quite come out the same because it had another color underneath it. I love blending the colors together and layering them and just seeing what kind of crazy look I come out with. You know, it's fun to be a girl, seriously. And so there we go, looks like they're about the same. And then also I added, and this is like, if you do this look, and then you can add like some really wicked pink in here. And I just kind of get the color, whatever color I choose. And I just kind of blend it out, like feather it out in this corner. And add the color that's going to bring out the color in your eyes. Like mine are like a navy green color or mossy green. Pinks, purples. You know, you could just, you know, add that in there as a splash of color. And it'll help really highlight, you know, in... and show your eyes. And then I used, trying to remember, a gray. I think it was this one right here. This gray right here. Just to add some different look, you know, different little bit of different color in there. And, yeah. But you could add that splash of color in there too. You could put some crazy pink, and you could kind of even take the color, close the lid, and just kind of come down into the, you know, underneath here and even up underneath here if you wanted to go even more dramatic. I'm trying to think of those, like this one I think is this one's lighter than this one, so I want to kind of darken it up a bit. My kitty is meowing. He's at the, I won't let him in. He's mad at me. I just took him out and he's like dying. He thinks he's my big kitty and he needed to go outside. So blend all that out. You know, I don't want the harsh lines. Some people like the lines and that's fine. It's no big deal. Everybody to each their own. Everybody has the things they like. I love the smoky Kardashian eye look. I hope that is coming out. Sometimes it's hard to tell when you're doing a video and you're looking at the video and you're like, that looks like blah, you know. So anyway, so let's just go from there. I'm going to show you how I do my, I always use a gel liner. And this one is Wet n Wild. And it looks black, but it is an extremely dark, dark purple. Which I'm very, very happy about. Because purple will bring out my green eyes. So I was really happy that it was purple. I didn't know they had a dark purple. And then I'll show you kind of like how I do my, gel. If you don't do a gel, I love gel liners. They're just my favorite. So I hope you kind of see what I'm doing here. I kind of start in the middle and then blend it out a little bit. And then I kind of go in to the tear duct area. Okay. So I hope you guys can see me doing this. Because I need a mirror. Because I'm blind. I'm gonna add some more liner to be sure I have enough. Because I love the wing-tipped look. And that's what I always do. Always. So I'm going to go to about... Let me think. Let me see. Okay. I do not. If you want to keep your eyes looking like they're going like this and up, you're going to stop about right here with that gel liner. Just stop. Don't go down anymore. Because your eye is naturally going down. And if you keep following your lid, you're taking that eyeliner down. And it's going to be down. You know what I mean? It's going to look down and droopy. So you're going to stop like right here, right? And then you're going to come right back up here in the corner and drag it down and meet that line. So I hope you guys can see what I'm doing. And so you're going to take it and you're going to drag it. See how it's got that winged? I hope you can see it. And I'm doing this by looking in the camera, so I hope I do it right. You're going to come up here and you're going to meet that line that you didn't fill in. I know, it's gonna look totally crappy because I'm not... The other side's gonna look better because I was able to pay better attention, but I hope you can see how I sweep that down to meet that line. And then, there you go. If it's too low of a line, then you're gonna... You're gonna use some spit. And then you're gonna just kind of go up underneath it and swoop it up, and then you're gonna twist that Q-tip around so you're not adding gel all over the side of your face. You're going to clean that up and it's going to pull that back up in the direction you want. After you do that, you're going to want to then take your blending brush. You don't have that sharp line and kind of just blend that back out again so you don't want that, you know, crazy sharp line. And then also, I love Elf's. I say it's gold, but it's copper. And I don't apply it like, you know, I don't do that. I don't draw it on there. I turn it to the side and I dab right on top of that. See, I'm just like such a pro at that part. And I dab it and I twist it to be sure I'm getting a lot of glitter on there. And then you get more glitter. If you're trying to draw it on there, you're going to have like clump of glitter, no glitter, clump of glitter. So if you turn it sideways and dab it from the long ways, if you can see what I mean. And then turn it around while you're doing it, twist it, and you're going to get all that glitter on there all the way across and be like, I'm a wild, sexy woman. So, anyways, I hope that helped you guys. That's how I get my dramatic looks. I always do smoky look no matter what. I don't care. I can smoke out light colors. I can smoke out these gorgeous purples. Anything that I do, I smoke it out. And I use a minimal of 4 colors every time. And I layer it. So, you know, a lot of people make comments about the color of my eyes. You saw, you know, my eyes. My eye over here with no makeup on. My eye did not pop as good as it does as when I'm, you know, add colors to my lid that make my green eyes pop. If you go back and look, you probably see the difference. The glitter makes my eyes sparkle. It pulls out the green. And my son says I have Edward's eyes from the Collins family. So, yeah, he's crazy. But use the colors that go with your eyes. Learn to work with them and deal with them. Like, I'm not really a pink person, but I could do a smoky look like this, and then let me try to get it open. I'll show you real quick. I hope we have unlimited minutes on this channel, because mine does, and pretty much in my old channel. And so I could just jab all my little freaking head off. Okay. There, here we go. Okay. So normally, like this beautiful, gorgeous, any of these pinks would maybe before a color I would not use. So I would just take that pink and just put it in the corner right here. I put it around the tear duct. And that right there will help pull to other people when they're talking to me. They're, you know, helps that the green come out in my eye. And I'll come around that corner even. Close your eyes so you don't get shadow in there. And just helps that green pop out. So find what colors go work for you. Go talk to One for all and all for one. If I'm saying her name right, I never can remember her name. I want to turn it around and say it wrong. But Charlene, she's amazing, awesome, I love her. She's the one that told me what colors went good with my eyes and made a huge difference because people always make comments about my eyes. And she's an awesome YouTuber and awesome with doing videos and does some wicked awesome looks of makeup, nails. And she's a positive BBW. And if you don't know what BBW means, it means big, beautiful woman. And I think she's just gorgeous. I would die to have her hair. So anyways, thank you guys so much for being on our channel. And if you have any videos you want us to do or you want to post a video to this, show me how you do your looks, whether it be smoked, whether it be your natural look, whatever, go for it. We would love to watch it. So anyways, from a different pretty from Kelly, have a great week. And I love you. See you next week. Bye.